Let us prove theorem 5 on connected spaces, which states that if AI is a family of connected subsets of X, a topological space X, such that intersection of AI is not null. You take any number of them, any number of AIs, the intersection of them is not null, then we have to prove that union of all those AI is connected. I hope you have understood the theorem. So what is given? Given each AI is connected. We have a connected family, a family of all connected subsets of X, with the property, if you take any number of them, the intersection of them is not null. To prove that union of all those is connected. Right? Okay. Suppose it is not connected, then it has got a separation. Say it has got separation, two sets B union C, two sets B and C. And this as a separation, no. So that is equal to two sets B union C, where B and C are separated sets, or in other words, I can have B and C are non-empty, disjoint, open sets, right? Okay. Now this union AI, let us call it as A, right? So A equal to B union C. What are B and C? B and C are two non-empty disjoint open sets. Okay. Now, since each AI, what are each AI? All AIs are connected subsets of A, right? And A has a separation, B union C, A has a separation. Each AI is subset of A, each AI is subset of A. Right, A has a separation. So by one of the theorems, this connected subset will be either completely in B, the first set B, or completely in C. Completely in C. And this will happen for all I. For any connected, see, we have a family of connected, sets. We have a family of connected subsets of X. So for all these, either all of them are in B or all of them are in C. Let us prove why all of them are in B and all of them are in C. Why not some of them in B and some of them in C? Okay. If some of them are in B and some of them in C. Okay. Now suppose some AI is contained in B, some AJ is contained in C, and we know that B and C are, non-empty, disjoint, open sets. So, disjoint net. B intersection C is disjoint. Right? So, we'll imply that since AI is in B, this AJ is in C, and we have B intersection C is null. Therefore, AI intersection AJ has to be null. But what they have given? Remember? What they have given? They have given that this part. What is this? Take any number of them, the intersection is not null. Intersection is not null. So I have AI intersection AJ here. This is also not null. Right? This is also not null. So I cannot have some of them in B and some of them in C. So this is correct. So all of them, for all I, either all of them are in B or all of them are in C. Okay. Now, since all of them are in B or in C, what about their union? Since all of them are in B, right? This is happening for all I. Therefore, union of them will be in B. Similarly, suppose if all of them are in C, then union of all of them will be in C. And what is our union? A is nothing but A. So, A is either in B or I've got A is either in C. So, A is contained in B and A is contained in C. And our, A is nothing but B union C. So since A is either completely in B or completely in C, suppose it is completely in C. Suppose our A is completely in C and we have A is B union C, will imply what? Will imply that B is null. Or if A is completely in B and also we have got A is equal to AB union C, then C will be equal to null. Right? But what are B and C? B and C are non-empty, disjoint, open sets. Non-empty. But I am getting one of them is empty here. This is again contradictions. So, I am getting again and again contradictions, right? See, I got a contradiction here. That means what? Why we got contradiction? Because we assumed it is not connected. So, therefore, union AI has to be connected. And that completed the theorem. Hence, the proof of the theorem.